It's my body and my life. Don't I get to decide if I want to marry and who I want to marry? My name is Samara. I'm performing at the She Thing because it's a great platform. The money is going up to charity and it's a lot of fun performing on stage and playing someone else. The message of the show for me is letting people be, not judging people for who they are and just accepting everyone like they are. Thank you.
My sexual orientation is not what majority of people might like to display. If I were to be a little less subtle, I would say I'm into girls. And being a girl myself, that would make me a lesbian. I don't understand why people have this irresistible urge to shorten words. Lesbians are termed as les, lesy, lesbo, lesbi. How hard can it be to add another 2 to 4 additional letters there? Or is this meant to insult us? I don't understand you, you straight people. See what I did there? No one should be defined based on their sexual orientation. And just because I'm a lesbian does not mean that I'm ugly and can't get boys, or that I'm a tomboy, or that it's just a phase. Do I hate that term? No one ever goes around telling a girl, "It's okay, you'll get over him, it's just a phase." And why would anyone think they can tell other people who they can be with and not be with? We know about the rules, the regulations, and even the consequences. After all of this, if we still decide to follow our heart, why don't you just let us be? People are so opinionated, even with things that don't concern them. I tried to find out why that was, and then I realized some people will say anything to other people. For example, a general comment about gay marriage is, "What's next? People allowed to marry their dogs?" Did I hear dogs? I mean, what the F? Marriage is a consensual union between two adult human beings. How is that the same as marrying dogs? Not just that. Homosexuals are often put in the same category as pedophiles and necrophiliacs. I see no logical reasoning behind this. If it is because all of these groups of people have depraved sexual activity, I have something to say here. Pedophilia is when an adult person has sexual urges for a child. A child! It's a sickness! When pedophilia results in child molestation, it might have deep psychological impact on the victim. Not just that. If you think about it carefully, this might be considered as rape because there is no consent in a relationship. Necrophilia, on the other hand, is when one has sex with a dead person who might have objected to it had they been alive. Since the person is dead, their bodies are being abused. Get this, homosexual relationships are consensual. And just like any other straight relationship, there are real feelings involved. And then of course, there are the self-righteous people will bring in religion into the matter. We are who we are. We can far to me. Do you honestly think I would want to be with girls? What benefit would that bring me? I'm in constant fear of being banished by my friends, my family, my society. If it were my choice, I would most definitely have wanted to be a straight person, because it would have made my life so much more easier. But you don't get to choose your sexual orientation. No guy goes to sleep one day and wakes up thinking he wants to start dating other guys. Might feel like I have a lot of suppressed grudges, but being a lesbian in Bangladesh, I have to face discrimination on multiple levels every day. Apparently here, if one does not get married by when they're 24, it's a matter of grave concern, not just for one's family, but for all the relatives, who, if you think about it, should not really have a say in the matter. Have anyone thought of starting this rumor about this? Which went then? I have a European boyfriend who's madly in love with me and waiting for me with a diamond celebration. But my mother stopped me from it at the end. Marriage is a serious matter, and one that is life-altering. Should one only get married because their relatives are going to talk about it behind their backs? We know the biological clock is ticking. We have been told so all throughout our lives. But it's my body and my life. Don't I get to decide who I want to marry and if I want to marry at all? Ultimately, if you think about it, during the big wedding ceremony, when everyone goes back home well fed on kachi biryani, no one for once turns back to look at the bride and groom to see if they are actually happy. I want to get married to the person I am. I want to have a family of my own. But having a same-sex household here is like a utopian dream. People will throw stones at my house. I don't understand the concept of wedding. And stop with the discrimination. And please stop comparing people to animals. I know it's easier said than done. But change can only happen if there's positivity. Right?
Women and their sexuality is still a hushed topic in the larger spheres of society. But in our smaller intimate circles, we love making the jokes and sharing our deeds. So we asked around, what gets your pajamas off?
Soft kisses on my face, that bite on my neck,
watching Baywatch, the corner booth of the intimate cafe. We have to be so quiet.
When he picks me up,
hands caressing me under my shirt.
I want to wait until after.
My fingers intertwine his hair. We used to go on dates to my best friend's house.
Sneaking him in
through my balcony.
Just seeing him walking towards me, waiting for him to get home.
Right on my skin.
When I read those steamy, sexy scenes. When the bra snaps open.
I thought he'd leave me if I didn't.
bored, I imagine kisses and touches.
I don't want to be naked in front of anyone!
We used to meet on the roof. We had a funny dengue.
In Ashmiya, we would rent a boat and go for a ride.
Hi, Khuda! Toba, toba!
I loved him. I thought we would be together for an...
Moans. Moans are so sexy.
They call me nympho.
They call me poo.
But I love sex.
I love sex with my love.